Students, students of class 6, in the previous video we have discussed the summary of the banyan tree. Have you seen the banyan tree? Yes, a very large. Have you seen a mongoose? You have read in lesson number 9 that a mongoose can fight with and kill a snake. Have you read? Yes, look at the picture and read the lines given along with them. You can see in the picture there is a mongoose and cobra. The fight of the cobra and the mongoose is a classic drama often seen in India, and the outcome is largely the same outcome result. The mongoose is not immune to the venomous poisonous bite, but is faster and quicker in motion than the snake. Mongoose is very swift, fast and quick than snake. The cobra assumes a posture of defense and attempts to reach the animal by a sweeping strike, but the quick moving mongoose jumps out of reach and comes at the snake from another direction before the snake can get into striking position again. This constant continuous movement tires and discourages the snake, and the mongoose is finally able to jump in close and bury its teeth in a snake's neck, usually severing the joints of its vertebrae. Now, you must have seen a banyan tree. This is a story about what the author saw as a young boy when he was sitting in an old banyan tree in his grandfather's house. In this story, the author is at his grandparents' house, and there is a banyan tree. What did he see there? It has been described here. But now we will start part 1. Though the house and the grounds belong to my grandparents, the magnificent old banyan tree was mine chiefly because grandfather at 65 could no longer climb it. Now the writer says that once he went to his grandparents' house, and there was a very magnificent banyan tree, and now the writer says it was his because at that time his grandfather's age is 65 years old and he was unable to climb it. Its spreading branches, which hung to the ground and took root again, forming a number of twisting passages. Now it was very big and its branches were spreading, and it took root again and gave me endless pleasure. When writer saw this, he became very happy to see it. Among them were squirrels and snails. As you know, squirrels and snails also lived there. Butterflies also came there. So it was a very good scene. The tree was older than the house. It was older than the house, older than grandfather, yani more than 65 years old as Dehradun itself. I could hide myself in its branches. They are so thick that he could hide himself behind thick green leaves and spy on the world below. And spy means watch secretly what is happening there. Now, in this paragraph, he described who was his first friend. My first friend was a small gray squirrel. Students, have you seen squirrels? Yes, they live near the tree. So, one squirrel became his friend, arching his back and sniffing into the air. He seemed at first to resent my invasion of his privacy, but when he found that I did not arm myself with catapult or air gun, he became friendly. First of all, when writer went there, the squirrel think that it may be that he would attack on its privacy, but when he saw that he did not have any catapult or air gun, He means the squirrel, became friendly. And when I started bringing him pieces of cake and biscuit, he quite bold and was soon taking morsels. Morsels small pieces of food from hand. Before long, he was delving into my pockets and helping himself to whatever he became so friendly that when he saw that I had cake and biscuits, he dealt into his pocket and whatever he could find, he took from there. He was a very young squirrel, young, small, and his friends and relatives, as you can see in the picture, probably thought him foolish and had strong for trusting a woman. And now, generally, it is thought that the women are very clever. So his friends and relatives also thought that it is not good that he would make a friendship with a human being. In the spring season, how the banyan tree looked, it has been described here. The banyan tree was full of small red figs. Birds of all kinds flocked into its branches, came there. The red-bottomed bulbul, cheerful and greedy, parrots, manor, crow, squabbing with one another. During the fig season, the banyan tree was the noisiest place in the garden. At that time, it is the noisiest place. Parrots, manna, crow, bulbul, all these creatures came there. Now, students, have you seen in this story, comparative and superlative degrees are used. Noisest, noise, noiser, noisest, superlative degree. Halfway up the tree, I had built a crude, rough platform where I would spend the afternoon when it was not too hot. I could read there propping, leaning against the tree with a cushion from the living room. Treasure Island, Huckleberry Finn, and the story of Dr. Dolight were some of the books that made up my banyan tree library. And there, he sat there and he read the books. When I did not feel like reading, I could look down through the leaves at the bird below. When he became bored in reading after that, he spent some of his time watching the bird. And on one particular afternoon, I had a grandstand view. Grandstand view, a clear view from the best position. That classic of Indian wilds, a fight between a mongoose and cobra. And one day he saw a classic drama of a fight between a mongoose and a cobra. Thank you, students.